Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with a very important topic. Now the topic is agriculture in concurrent list. Now very important from polity point of view, very important for political science optional students, and very important for sociology and public administration optional students. Now should agriculture be brought to the concurrent list? Now this is the debate that is simmering of late. Now should there be an alteration in how the federalism is working in India? Now in India what we have three lists. We have the concurrent list, we have the state list, union list, and the fourth list is the subsidiary list. Now when it comes to the working of the federation in India, the working of the federalism in India, it is tilted towards the center, and a very important subject of agriculture is placed in the state list. It is not in the union list, or it's not in the concurrent list. Now when it comes to the marketing of the agriculture produce, it is the states that come out with the laws with respect to the marketing of the agriculture products. Now agriculture product, whatever you are producing rice, you are producing wheat, you are producing pulses, soya bean, etc. Whatever you are producing, the farmer in of that particular state, he is allowed to sell that produce with respect to the laws of that particular state. And most of the laws of these particular states, they have been created since the colonial days. So these market laws that we have, they doesn't allow the farmer to sell it to some other state. So when it comes to the market of a particular crop of a particular state, it is actually confined to that state only. So what we have presently in lot number of states, we have the Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee Act. Though this act is melting, because we have also brought in National Agriculture Marketing, ENAM, Electronic National Agriculture Marketing. Now what does this ENAM do? Now this ENAM allows the farmer to get online, to sell its purchase online, so that he can get better output, he can get better result out of it. So this is what the farmer is actually doing now. But this ENAM is not widely prevalent. The farmers are not aware about this ENAM. Most of the states that we are having in India, out of the 29 states, still APMC Act is prevalent in good number of states. So if you want to revitalize agriculture, we have the Dalvey Committee report. That is about the doubling of the farmer's income. So in that report, he has highlighted the market. Marketing is the next domain that we should be focusing in agriculture. It's not about the agriculture yield. It's about how the farmer is able to market itself. Because it's the middleman that is actually deriving a lot of benefits out of it, deriving a lot of profits. So it actually eats away most of the profits. So if you want better profits, it is important that you should be marketing your produce in a better manner. Now, how can that be done? That can be done if we work on this marketing sector. So, marketing sector is not only about allowing the farmer to sell its produce at whole India level or at international level, or creating up just a medium in terms of some software that is electronic media. But for that, we need to actually come out and design certain structures in the real life, in the physical world. Now, what are those things? First of all, we need to work on logistics. And secondly, we need to work on roads. Logistics mean like a courier facility from one place to another. A farmer should have access to those logistic facilities. And second is with respect to the roads. And thirdly, a very important thing that is required is with respect to the storage facilities. Now, that is not available in the nooks and the corners of the villages. So instead of spending more on providing subsidy to the farmers, we need to actually empower the farmer by setting up these centers, the storage facility, the cold storage facility, so that they can store their facility there, they can have a better transportation logistic facility and the road availability. That will actually help in enhancing the income of the farmer. Now in this class I will also be discussing with a very important scheme, that is the Bhuwantar Kisan Yojana. Now what is this Bhuwantar Yojana? Now this Bhuwantar Yojana has been implemented in Madhya Pradesh. Now this is the scheme that is being studied by the Union government. Now, when it comes to the Narendra Modi government in particular, it hadn't worked for the farmers, and that is the reason why its voting share had declined in Gujarat. Now, why the farmers have not voted for Narendra Modi? Now, the biggest reason behind that is that their status, their economic status has not improved. Now, how can we improve the economic status of the farmers? The economic status of the farmers can be improved only if we will assure them better income. And for that, already government of India is having MSP. Now, what is this MSP? Now, MSP is a price, minimum assured price, that the government will be paying to the farmers for procuring the yield. But when it comes to MSP, it is for a particular number of crops only. It is not spread holistically in the agriculture domain. But in Madhya Pradesh, what we are having is, instead of procuring the yield, government is paying them the amount at which they have sold in the market and the amount of the MSP. So they are actually bridging this gap that can assure the economic viability of agriculture. So the biggest challenge that we are facing in India is about the economic viability of agriculture. Now, this economic viability of agriculture can be assured if we will bridge this gap. And it is not possible to actually procure all the produce, because there is a limited capacity of the government to distribute it. Because what we are witnessing is that lot of the food grains, they get actually rotten up when the government procures. There is, because the kind of the distribution system that we are having, it is not foolproof. Though we are focused on the targeted PDS system, but again, the system is not very foolproof. So we need to replicate this Bhuwantar scheme of Madhya Pradesh throughout India. Plus, we need to work on the marketing aspect as per the Dalwai committee. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you have any sort of query with respect to these topics. And you can join my offline classes in Delhi and in Chandigarh. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.